So today we are going to discuss a very, very, very important topic, data sufficiency. Data sufficiency. This is going to be the final topic of your aptitude. Yes, students. So how good you are able to understand the topics and how good you are able to respond to the topic is now actually being tested in data sufficiency. Data sufficiency is said to be one of the very important concepts in test of reasoning that will test how good you are able to get the point. So student, actually for your information, the most important thing just want to share to you, as far as the present examination trend is concerned, it is not the questions that are directly been asked to you. So questions are not actually put to you straight away. Questions are always put to you with an intention of testing how good you are able to understand the topic. Student, I want to tell you that the very significance of competitive examination is not to test your knowledge, but to test your skill. The significance of aptitude is only to test how good you are at the topic. It is not that how much knowledge you have it. The problem in education system, actually, if you can see that, education system is providing you is a great significance of knowledge for sure, but not the skill. Because the skill is something that student has to develop of his own. I hope you understand this. That is the reason why in competitive examinations, the stress is more on testing your skill rather than on your knowledge. How good you are at the topic is being tested in aptitude. So further reason, actually you have two important topics. One is the data sufficiency and the data analysis. Data analysis is actually been discussed in test arithmetic. Therefore, that is an arithmetic topic. As far as our test of reasoning is concerned, the significant topic in test of reasoning is data sufficiency. This is going to be the final topic in test of reasoning. So with this, we come to an end. How good you are able to get the point. Okay, student? So what is data sufficiency? How the question is important? I want to tell you that. Yes, students? Yeah, very good morning, ma'am. So very good morning to all of you. Now, students, there's... Okay. So you want me to explain bridulation, something like? Okay. Yeah, I understand that. Because reasoning topics are always tricky. Yeah, obviously. So more the topics, when the topic is already done, you will be having a lot of confusions for sure. Student, one advantage you have certain is, as we are discussing aptitude in the very beginning, so the advantage is, because you can practice and you can have a lot of questions, a lot of practice and all that for the remaining 2 to 3 years of time. Another 2 years of time is certainly there for you. Therefore, you can go for a rigorous practice, and your faculty will be there in your college, and you can ask them any doubts and they will be ready to answer all of such, because the topic is all completed. You see, students, nowadays, aptitude is going to be the very first stepping stone for your CRT program. After aptitude and of course your what you call communication skills, group discussions and all that. And in such a scenario, the best part in appearing for CRT program for campus recruitment is to complete aptitude, because this topic is going to play very, very important role in every competitive examination. So once you are completed your intermediate, means you are eligible for some government employments as well, because once you cross your age limit and you are eligible for government employment as well. So that is the reason why, because once the topic is done, man, so you can appear for any of the competitive examinations you may like. So yes, we fortunately, yes. What, student? I did not get you. What you are asking me? Yesterday? Yeah, this is reasoning only. So whatever the topic I am telling you is comes under test of reasoning. You understand that? Right. Right, students, so because of the reason, because completing the topic in advance, that really gives a lot of advantage for your career, okay? Students, Now, yes, we discussed data sufficiency. Before we start the topic, let us understand the significance of this topic. Student, data sufficiency. Actually, questions are given in two ways. Questions are usually put in two ways. For example, if I say that x plus y is equal to 4 and then 2x minus y is equal to 6. So let me suppose that I just give you two statements, two information, x plus y is equal to 4, 2x minus y is equal to 6. Basing on this particular two data, can you answer find the value of x? Find the value of x. Okay, student, please do not respond, man. Don't respond to this question. Just listen to me. Actually, this is the kind of questioning you will be having in regular and routine examinations, isn't it? First, you will be given data and then question follows. Is it? It is the most relevant and it is the most appropriate way of putting the question to you, isn't it? So, you will be able to get the value of x basing on the given two statements. Simple. You will be able to get the value of x basing on the two statements, which mean to say that data is given in the beginning and then it follows question. It is the most relevant way of putting the question to you. It is the most significant and routine way. For example, if I give you information something like this. For example, student. For example, I just give you that. A is east of B. City A is east of B. And then B is south of C. For example, if the information is given something like this, then the question may be like this. Then in what direction is A? Then in what direction is A with respect to C? So this kind of questions usually we get. So what actually happens, you know, first you will be given the data. First you will be given the data and then question follows. This is the most relevant form of giving the question, isn't it, man? It is the most relevant form of giving the question. It is the routine form. But in data sufficiency, it is totally a different, questioning actually. It's a different ball game. It is not like that it is your routine, but it is a totally a different ball game. How it is different, you know? So actually, you will be given the question first without giving any data. Without giving any data, you will be given first. Then you can ask me, sir, how we can answer the question without data? That is what data sufficiency is all about. So first you will be given some question. So you immediately look for data. Oh my God, without data, how can I answer? Yes, that is what data sufficiency is. Now this is going to be a very interesting question. Please come to this class. So probably you will be able to get this class now basing on this data. For example, student, I just want to put some question to you. Here we go. For example, if a question is given to you, find the value of x. Find the value of x. So this is the question that is given to you. Oh my God. Without giving any data, how can you really answer this question? Isn't it? You are under big confusion, sir. Where is the data, man? If there is no data, how can we answer the question? No, this is interesting. Therefore, man, I'll be giving you some data. Just look at that. I'm going to give you data. Here we are going to. Yeah, yeah. Very good morning, students. So please be attentive. Be ready. Students, now you're supposed to get the answers. Be ready, man. I'm giving data and I'm going to ask the questions to you. Be ready with your laptops and now ready to respond. Now, this particular class for the coming 2 to 3 days is going to be very interactive. Because I just want to see that how you are able to get the answer. Are you ready, man? Now, here we go. Come on. Let me suppose here is the answer. For example, data number 1, x cube is equal to 8. Come on, student. If x cube is equal to 8, now you please tell me, can we get the answer for x with the data number 1 alone? Yes or no? Please tell me. Tell me, student, can we get the answer? Please tell me, if x cube is equal to 8, can we get the answer for the question that is given to you? Straight away, actually, question is put to you straight away without actually giving the data. Now, actually, I am supplying the data for you. Please respond. Student, I am waiting for your response, man. What is the value of x? If x cube is equal to 8, please respond, is the given data is enough or not? Student, you please don't give the answer for x. You please only say that is data number 1 is sufficient or not. That's it. Don't say the value of x. Yes or no, please tell me, is the given data sufficient or no? That's it. Yes or no? That's very good. That's very good. Absolutely. So be ready, ma'am. Now from here onwards, now this is your responsibility to respond to me quickly, ma'am, because this particular class is going to be very interactive for your information. Okay? Now I want to give you one more information. Please listen to me. X is a natural number. X is a natural number. For your information, student, for your information, to answer this particular question, if x cube is equal to 8, x is equal to 2, which mean to say that x is a natural number, this particular information is not at all necessary to answer the given question. The question is find the value of x. For your information, my dear student, to answer the given question, only data 1 is sufficient, data 2 is not required. And hence we declare that, come on student, the answer for the given question is only 1 is sufficient. Only 1 is sufficient. So this is going to be your answer. Okay, ma'am? This is really very interesting, you know. For your information, my dear student, actually to answer the given question, you are not supposed to get the value of x or something like, only to say that whether the given data is sufficient or not, that's it. I hope you understand this. Come on, student, I hope that you are getting the point right. Okay? So without any confusion, you get the point right. Right? Okay, student. So this is all about data sufficiency. Please understand that the questions may be even more tricky.
Somebody asking me to tell me the topic name. Students, the topic name is data sufficiency. Data sufficiency. This is a very, very, very important topic for your competitive examination, data sufficiency. Student, in data sufficiency, it is not necessary to get the answer. It is only to say whether the given data is sufficient or not. We don't require to know the answer. Okay, ma'am? Now, let me move on to next question. Question number 2. Here we go. Question number 2. So, once again, I want to put some question to you. Now, please come, student. Now, please don't send any messages. Ready? Right. Don't send any messages. Be ready. I am just going to give you some question to you. Be ready. Right? Now, here we go. Question number 2. Find the value of px. Again, find the value of px. Find the value of x. Okay, ma'am? Now, here we go. Information number 1. Data number 1, x square is equal to 4. Student, please tell me, is data number 1 is enough to get the answer or not? Please tell me yes or no. That's it. Yeah, please tell me. No student, I tell you. No student. Please tell me, yes or no, that's it. No other further information is enough. You please respond yes or no, that's it. I don't want the value of x. You just only say that whether the given data is sufficient or not, that's it. Yes? That's very good. Exactly. No. So, you mean to say that? Absolutely no. Because x square is equal to 4 means, the student, we get two options actually. X value can be either plus or 2 or it can be minus 2, isn't it? That is the reason why you are under confusion that you are unable to get the answer for this given question, and hence you said no. That's very well done. Okay, student. Yes, I understand that. I understand your difficulty. Therefore, data number one is absolutely not sufficient. Let me give you second data. Come on, student. 2x minus 4 is equal to 6. Tell me, student, second data is enough or not? Tell me. Is second data is sufficient or not? Tell me, ma'am. Is second data is sufficient? Absolutely, absolutely. Second data, I am asking you to find whether the second data is sufficient or not, ma'am. What is your point, student? What is your point? Yeah, that's right, that's right. You said that, yes, absolutely. So, second data is absolutely sufficient. Therefore, my dear student, to answer the given question, we are making use only second data. Therefore, only 2 is sufficient. Therefore, your answer should be only 2 is sufficient. I hope you understand this. So, given the 2 datas, you have to decide whether which data is sufficient or not. That is the significance of this topic. Okay? Let me give you one more question, man. Here we go. Question number 3. Come on, student. Find the value of x. Find the value of x. Find the value of x. So, this is question number 1. So, come on, student. The first information, x square is equal to 9. Okay, man? And second information, x is a positive number. X is a positive number. Please, student, respond to me. Now, to answer the given question, you should tell me which of the given data is required. Come on. Come on, student. Yeah, please respond to me. The question is already given to you. Find the value of x. To get the value of x, you must tell me which of the given data is sufficient. Tell me. Yeah. Student, I am asking you, please respond. That's very good, student. That's very good. So, exactly. So, student, yes. So, what is the question is? When x square is equal to 9, you are under impression that x value can be either plus 3 or minus 3, which means to say that there was a confusion. There was a certain confusion that x value can be plus 3 or minus 3, which means to say that we require some more information to get it confirmed. And the second information, x is a positive number, which means to say that this particular value is ruled out. So, minus 3 value is absolutely ruled out. It is only because x is a positive number. And hence, x square is equal to 9, x is a positive number. We can confirm that your answer is x is equal to 3. That we can confirm both from 1 and 2. Both 1 and 2 are required to get the answer. Both data 1 and 2 are required to get the answer. Any one statement is not absolutely enough. To get the answer. To get the answer, I would say that we require both the data 1 and 2. So, this is the third questioning, my dear students. Okay, man? Let me give you one more example. What is students? What you want me to say? Am I clear to you, student? Did you understand what did I say, both 1 and 2 are enough? It is only because to confirm the value of x, we would require data 1 as well as data 2. With the single information, we cannot get the answer for your information. Am I right? I hope yes, I am right. Okay. Right. Now, student, now I just want to give you one more question. Now, please confirm. Yeah, question number 4. Find the value of x. Find the value of x. Okay? Now data number one, x plus y is equal to 4. Okay, man? And the second information, 2x plus 2y is equal to 8. Please tell me, from the given two informations, can we get the answer for x? Please respond. Please respond, man. Sure, sure, I will explain you. Yeah. No, square, if it is in square, it can be plus 2 or minus 2, no. Square means plus or minus, man. You understand, you have in your school level, okay. Yeah, tell me. Yes, student, please respond. Okay, okay, please respond. Is the given data sufficient or not? Tell me. Can we answer the value of x from the given informations? Please, I have provided you two informations. Do respond whether this information is sufficient to get the answer. Yes. Exactly, absolutely, not sufficient, exactly. The reason is x plus y is equal to 4. 2x plus 2y is equal to 8. Both are same equations actually for your information. If you cancel x in both second equation also reduces to x plus y is equal to 4 only, because you can see this, yes. Which means to say that we have two same statements, x plus y is equal to 4 in statement 1, x plus y is equal to 4 in statement 2, which means to say that your answer should be data not sufficient. Data not sufficient. I hope you understand, my dear students. Therefore, for this question, your answer should be data not sufficient. Students, in data sufficiency, now please, okay, if there is any confusion, I'll explain you. Please look at this. So, in data sufficiency, student, under the heading of data sufficiency, we usually handle four different kind of answers. Number one, if only one is sufficient, this is one kind of answer you can go for. This option is there, if only one is sufficient. And second we have, if only two is sufficient. Okay, man? Therefore, this is one option we can go for. And then we have both 1 and 2 are required. Both 1 and 2 are required. This is another option available. And finally, we have, if data is not sufficient. Data is not sufficient. So we have four different options to handle with. Student, please try to understand, man. So we have four different options to handle for data sufficiency. If data 1 is sufficient, data 2 is sufficient, if both 1 and 2 are not required, and even from both data given, we cannot answer the question. These are the four different options we are going to handle to answer this question. Student, please respond. Are we ready to answer the question? Yes, please respond, man. Are we ready? Please respond. If you think you are ready, then I start putting questions to you. Now you are supposed to get the answer. Come on, student, please respond. Yes or no? Are we ready, man? I want to get the answer from you. Are we ready? Yes or no? If you think we are ready, then I will straight away start the question. Now we will be handling some beautiful questions now onwards. So you really enjoy dealing data sufficiency unit. This is a beautiful question really. Please tell me. Yes or no, man? Yes. So people say yes. So I can understand that. Yes, you are very enthusiastic to get the answer. Now here we are going to handle. Ready? Come on. Yes, students, very good, very good, very good. Right? Now question number 5. Ready, students? So be ready with your laptops and get the answer quickly. Here we go. How many sons does Mohan have? How many sons does Mohan have? Data number one. Mohan has three children. Mohan has three children. Come on, student, please just look at the question. Don't answer the question right at the moment. Please take your time. I'm not in hurry. Take your time. Okay. Right. Data number two. Mohan has only two daughters. Student, be ready and get the answer. What is your answer for question number five? Quick. You please respond. Whether one is required, two is required, you please mention in words. Mention in words. Please mention in words. Question number five. You please say only one is sufficient, only two is sufficient, both one and two are required. Please mention. Question number five. Remember, student, you are answering question number five. You make sure that. Oh, that's very good. That's very good. Wonderful, student. Wonderful, wonderful. So what you said is absolutely correct. Exactly. Yes. Student, my question is, how many sons does Mohan have? My question is, how many sons does Mohan have? I said that Mohan has three children. He said that only Mohan has three children, which means to say that those three children can be either sons or daughters. Or son or daughter, something like so, we may be having different combinations for sure. But student, when it is given that Mohan has only two daughters, come on man, when Mohan has only two daughters, which mean to say that the remaining person should be son. Which mean to say that from both data 1 and 2, we can conclude that Mohan has only one son. Therefore, my dear student, your answer should be both 1 and 2 are required. Both 1 and 2 are required to get the answer. I hope you understand this. Okay, man. So, question number 5, your answer should be both 1 and 2. Yes, student, yes, any objections from your side? Please respond, man. If you have any objections, please respond. If there is any objection, I am waiting for your objections if there is any such. If you think there is no such, then I will go to the question straight away. Okay, man? Right. So it seems that, yes, we are absolutely clear. Now let me give you question number 6. Here we go. Come on, student. How many sons does Vishal has? How many sons does Vishal has? Ready? Data number one. Vishal has one child. Data number two. Vishal has only one daughter. Please do respond, man. Please do respond. Question number six. I'm waiting for your answer. Question number six. What, student? What is your point, man?
What about sons? One son only, no? Student, one son only, because two daughters means one son. Because total three children, right? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Please answer my question, man. You are answering question number 6. Please make sure that you are answering question number 6. Very interesting, very interesting, very interesting. Student, you please make sure that you are, before you answer your question, make sure that you don't make any mistake. Yeah, 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 yeah. No, student, no, 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 no. So this is absolutely misleading, you know. This is absolutely misleading. It is interesting to see that almost 90% of the answers so far I got, they said both 1 and 2 are required. But for your information, student, both 1 and 2 are required is not correct answer. Please think once again. Please think once again. Please think once again. No hurry, no hurry, no hurry. We are not in hurry, man. You can straight away think. Right, now you get the point. Now you get the point, right? Yeah, student, that is the reason why I ask you to think once again. Please think once again, because I could see that many of you are saying both 1 and 2 are required. But both 1 and 2 are required is not actually correct, man. Both 1 and 2 are required is not actually correct. Wonderful. Now, yes, you get the point right. You get the point right. Absolutely, absolutely. Student, if my question is how many sons does Vishal has? Vishal has only one child. One child in the sense the child can be daughter or son. Okay, data number 1 you can straight away forget. But Vishal has only one daughter, has only one daughter. It is clearly mentioned that Vishal has only one daughter. Student, when it is given that Vishal has only one daughter, which is a clear indication that Vishal is having no sons. What, man? It is given that Vishal has only one daughter, which is a clear indication that he has having no sons at all. So for your information to answer the given question, you require only second data to confirm. Hence, your answer should be only 2 is sufficient. Has only one daughter. Vishal has only one daughter. Which means to say that he is having no other children. I hope only one daughter. It is a clear indication that Vishal seems to be having no other children. If you ask me, sir, how many children you have? If I say that I have only one daughter, it is an indication that I don't have any other children. I hope you understand, man. Tell me, student, yes or no? Yes or no, man? That's very good, that's very good. Yeah, that's important, man. That is important. Somebody asked me, sir, but we can understand in a different direction. Yeah, that is very important. Yes, we can also understand in different directions. Not required, actually. Student, okay, I just put some question to you. Student, please listen to me, man. Please listen to me. I'm going to give you 2 statements. Please listen to me. Are you ready? Right? Please listen to me carefully. Carefully. Please listen to me carefully. I'm going to put some questions to you. Okay, I'm just going to put some questions to you. Please listen to me. I have one daughter. I have one daughter. Statement 1. I have only one daughter. Remember. I have one daughter. Statement 1. Statement 2. I have only one daughter.
Is these two statements make any difference? Tell me. Are these two statements make any difference? Are these two, oh wonderful, somebody already given their versions. I'm so enthusiastic to get the answer from you. Student, am I clear to you? I just want to read out my statements once again. Listen to me. Statement one. I have one daughter. Statement number two. I have only one daughter. Are these two statements make any difference? Are these two statements make any difference? Yes or no? Are these two statements make any difference? Yes or no? Yes, no? Yes. Yes. How yes do you know? Listen to me. I have one daughter. Which means to say that in statement number one, I am only giving you, I have one daughter. I am not giving you how many sons do I have. I said I have one daughter. In the statement, I am not giving any clue how many sons do I have. But in second statement, I said I have only one daughter. You can take it granted, I have no sons at all. I have one daughter. I have only one daughter. Does it make any difference? Very logical, you know. Very logical, very logical. Student, yes or no, man? Yes or no? Yeah, only one daughter. When you say only one daughter, when somebody says, I have only one daughter, I would say this, if I don't have any other children, I have only one daughter. But if I say, I have one daughter, if I say, I have one daughter, which means, I'm not actually disclosing whether do I have any sons or not. This is called verbal reasoning. This is called verbal reasoning. Student, I hope you understand my point. One daughter means? No, man. One daughter means one daughter, many sons. One daughter, one son. It can be like anything. But if I say only one daughter, student, please understand, man. That is the reason why in the beginning I told you to follow newspaper, daily newspaper. If you do not newspaper daily, you will be missing some important verbal reasoning skills. Because we need to keep the words in practice. Otherwise, we will land in a very big confusion. You understand that? Okay. Student, am I clear to you, student? That's very good. That's very good. Okay, ma'am. So, therefore, your answer is this. Now, here we go. Question number 7. Here we go. Please look at that. How many sons does Suresh have? Okay. Now, data number 1. Suresh has 5 children. Suresh has 5 children. Okay. Data number 2. Suresh has 2 daughters. Come on, man, please do respond. Very logical, you know. Very logical. That is the reason why reasoning is always a very interesting topic. It is one of the very decided. Come on, student, please respond. Question number 7.
Yeah, that's very good. That's very good. That is a very good point. That is a very good point. Yeah, student, exactly. Data not sufficient. Why, man? Why, man? Why? Data is absolutely sufficient. You see, Suresh has 5 children. Suresh has 2 daughters. I said 2 daughters, which mean to say that 2 daughters means he has other children as well. So when it is given 2 daughters, we can take it granted that the remaining 3 should be sons. I think you understand this. Therefore, we can understand that the remaining 3 should be sons. Therefore, your answer must be both 1 and 2 are required. Both 1 and 2 are required. Okay? Now here we go. Question number 8. How many sons? How many sons does Pavan have? So let me suppose that this is the question I just give you. Let me see how you answer this question. Data number 1, I must say that Pavan has 5 children. Data number 2. Pavan has more sons than daughters. Tell me, student. Pavan has more sons than daughters. Tell me, student. So tell me, what is your answer for this question? Question number 8. So as we go ahead, the questions becomes more tricky, more confusing actually. You must be able to understand that. More tricky, more confusing, very interesting. Come on, make it fast. Wonderful, 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 wonderful man, wonderful. Very good, very good, very good. That's a very well done. No, student, please think once again. If you could able to answer the question, then you said data sufficient, otherwise data not sufficient. Exactly, that's very good. The reason is Pavan has 5 children. Out of the 5 children, we don't know how many sons and of course how many daughters. We don't know how many sons and how many daughters. It is only given that Pavan has more sons in the son case. 4 sons, 1 daughter is possible, man. And 3 sons, 2 daughters is also possible. Out of the 5, if it is given that more sons than daughters, the chances can be taken like this. 4 sons, 1 daughter. Or chance number 2, 3 sons and 2 daughters, which mean to say that data is absolutely not sufficient. Still, the question seem to be a little confusing. Hence, your answer must be data is not sufficient. What, man? I hope you understand my point. Get the point? Very well done, very well done, very well done. Yes, students, so okay, very fine. But still I expect the response should be even more because not all the people seem to be responding. I expect you, the people, should respond without any confusion. Okay, ma'am? So with this, we come to an end of our session for today. And in next class, we continue with this data sufficiency because more complicated questions and more interesting questions we are going to discuss in this topic. Right, students? So please take care. And soon your college is going to be reopened. And once you get to the college, you will not be having this much of time to get the topic of aptitude. So fortunately, you got very good time. So this is a very very positive side of your academic, because this is going to be very useful for your career. Thank you, students. So again, we will be meeting in the next class. We continue with